Okay, good afternoon, dear ladies. Let's bless Bezrat Hashem that we will all have the school to greet Mashiach Tzidkenu Barachamim Mu'im Bimra Biyamin Amen. Eliyahu Navi, Eliyahu Tishpi, Eliyahu Giladi, Bimra Yama Mashiach Lavid, Eliyahu Navi Zekor Tov. And we will all have the school to see the building of Beit HaMikdash HaShishi Bimra Biyamin Amen. Ki Ayin Bainu Bishu Adnai Tzion. Ata Takum Terachem Tzion Ki Et Lechanana Ki Vamuel. Hashivenu Adonai Lechem Vanashu Bachadesh Amenu Kekedem. We all have the zchut to go to Eretz Yisrael on the wings of eagle, and we all have part in Eretz Yisrael. B'shem Hashem nasev v'natzlech, en od milvado Hashem shpatai titach ufi agiti latecha, and everything that we are doing is b'shem kol Yisrael. And everything is, b'ezrat Hashem, this lesson is l'ilu nishmat, my brother-in-law, Rabbi Chaim Yosef Sharabi ben David ורחל עליו השלום תנשמת הצרצור החיים לילו נשמת אל חננאל הכהן בן רחל עליו השלום תנשמת הצרצור החיים and it's לילו נשמת הילד בת גאולה עליה השלום תנשמת הצרצור החיים לילו נשמת אנג'לה עדינה בת גולשרה עליה השלום תנשמת הצרצור החיים and all of the soldiers and all of the people that were murdered viciously by the terrorists, Aleim Hashalom Tishum Tam Tzora B'Chaim, and Bezrat Hashem, Hashem revenge their blood. And it's also for all of the captured, may Hashem bring them back home safely. Now Bezrat Hashem, and they have refuah, the ones that are already in Israel, the ones that are still in Gaza and are not here yet. May Hashem give them a health mentally and physically in B'tof Kalal Amo Yisrael. And Bezrat Hashem, it's also for Refuah Shlema. See, it's hard to לסגור את זה, שם, את הדבר הזה. And it's also Refuah Shlema for health mentally and physically to Kalal Amo Yisrael. Anybody that is healthy, may Hashem continue their health. May we all have the zchut to do tshuva. And it's for Refuah Shlema. של יונה בצר הזוהר, הדבורה בת שרנה, לאה בת פריידה, חווה בת חנה, שירלי בת נווה, שיראל בת איזבל אסתר, שרה בת מלכה, שרה רחל בת חסידה שרה, לאה פרלה בת חנה ברכה, אביגייל בת אסתר ברכה, שרה בת אסתר נחמה, איילת חיה, גיטל בת חווה, ראובן בן זינה, ג'נט שושנה חיה בת אולגה חיה, שמחה סימה בת שרה, רחמים בן שרה, ניסים בן שרה, אלור מיכאל בן שירן, הלני אורנה בת חן חנה, ארי שמעון בן מיתן מזל, אברהם בן רחל, ברל בן הילה, נונו רחל בת תמר, מדלנה מלכה בת שמחה, ירון בן יצחק ויבלונקה, משה אהרון בן רייזל, אלתר פרל בת גיטל, אדר בן מיטל, פנחס מנחם בן דליה, דוד אלדר בן אתי הגר, דבורה בת רחל, רונן בן רחל, ישראל חיים בן מרים, תמרה בת דבורה, אהרון בן אסתר, חיה בת דיאנה, that's a girl, please daven for them, שושנה בת בלה ברכה, שמחה בת גילה אסתר, מרדכי בן לאה, אלכסנדר בן רחל, שרה רחל בת שיראל, אוחנה בן אולגה, מיריה בת שיינה חנה, צילה בת חיה שרה, חיים אליעזר בן ראיה, משה ארז בן אסתר, אסתר סעידי, בת, שרה סעידי בת אסתר, ואימא של חנה סעידי, אברהם דוב בר, יחיאל צבי בן מלכה, נפתולי, שמעון יעקב אהרון בן מלכה, הבייבי, חיה אמיליה בת רג'ינה מזל, אילנה ארלין בת רבקה, מלכה בת אלינור מרגו, בעזרת השם, עדנה בת מרגלית, ישי בן מרים, שרה בת רינה, מלי מלכה בת מרים, another baby, שרה בת סיוון, another baby, מלכה הינדה בת מזל מרים, ויולט סגולה בת חנה, אברהם חיים בן שרה מלכה, רבקה אסתר בת נעמי, לינדה לאה בת שרה רחל, רוחמה אסתר בת שרה, גבריאל בן זילפה, יהודה בן תמרה, רמי בן ויקטוריה, שירה אביגייל בת אילנה צביה, שושנה בת מרים, מנדל נחמה בן, מנדל בן נחמה דינה, שמעון יעקב בן טובה, יפה בת טובה, חני חנה בת חווה, גלוריה דבורה בת גלדי שמחה, חיים אהרון בן שמחה, רחל בת דינה, לאה בת שרה, רבקה הילה הודיה בת רחל, ויקטור בן שרה, אורית בת שרה, רחל בת, ויסד רחל בת דינה, מזל בת ברת המרסלה, אמיל בן שרה, רחל פשה בת חנה, And Bezrat Hashem, Emunan El Batova, Mindel Bat Gitel Yehudit, Ariel Ben Rachel, Roman Ben Raya, Shoshana Bat Zvia, Laila Bat Zbeta, Shalom Ben Zvia, Eliyahu Ben Miriam, Sara Bat Marina, Laki Bela Bat Dilvar, Yafa Bat Tamara, David Ben Sara, וצביה בת לאה רחל, דבורה דוריס בת רחל, מישה בן נוריך. בעזרת השם, everybody, רפואה שלמה, and בסייעתא דשמיא תשובה מעומקא דליבה to all of us, that we will all repent and do the will of Hashem, like He wants us to do it. And another one, the husband of Shulamit דנינו, גם לו רפואה שלמה, and everybody that needs from א' to ת'. So, dear ladies, We are continuing respecting thy father and mother over here from Yalkut Yosef. This is from Yabi Omer, that the son of Rav Ovadia Yosef, is Yosef Yitzchak. He is the one that gathered everything here. So B'siyata Dishmaya, we are going to go to the part where the chapter 240, Reish Mem, and we are now in Halacha 55. And Ishtadlu Ahorim Tamid Levarech Et Yaldeim. So the parents should always bless their children, make an effort to bless their children. Even if we are angry with our children, please do not take any word that is not in place out. This is working on ourselves. That's why we came over here. The whole purpose is work, and we study the Torah that we will gentle our soul and that we'll emulate the attributes of Hashem. So it's not easy. Sometimes we are on fire, and sometimes we are more calm, but we have to. This is why we came over here, in order to be a deservable of the term human being. So even if our children make us angry, God forbid, don't curse and don't say something that is negative, because if something will happen to them, it's like we are shooting ourselves, because then we will be in agony and the sorrow, and we start davening to Hashem, praying to Hashem, please save them. But we did it with our mouth. There are two angels that are escorting us. On the right side is the good angel, and the left side, the not so good angel. And everything that we take out of our mouth, they say Amen. So even if you see that your children are naughty, so say that this energy will go to Torah. Okay, if you want to say something, the evil inclination wants you to say something, etc., say it in a positive way. And this we have to teach ourselves. It doesn't come, we are not born with this. We have to teach ourselves to do this. To say positive things, because chas v'shalom, God forbid that something happens to the children, because truly the nachat, the pleasure in life is when we see our children that they walk in the path of Hashem, in the path of God, and they are righteous, and they get married, and they have children, and everybody is happy. Then we are happy. If we don't see good things in our children, then we doesn't matter if we are rich or not rich, we are not satisfied. Because then it says that Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai says that World War III, so it's, if a person has problems with his children in the home, it's worse than World War III, because it's 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. So we need to work on ourselves in order that we will, and you know what, when we work on ourselves, we teach by example. So our children also see that. So they also learn. So Bezrat Hashem, like Rabbi Chaim Palagi says, do not complain. I don't complain about Hashem, and tell Hashem thank you for everything that you are doing. I'm saying it, Hashem, toda, toda kol David Rachmana letav David, en od milvado. Everything, there's nothing except Hashem. Hashem is big. He created the world. I lift up my eyes to the mountains and I ask Hashem, where will my help come? It will come from Hashem that created heaven and earth. So it doesn't matter what challenges we go through. And believe me, we also go through challenges, Baruch Hashem. And every time we fall, do what I do. I say, Hashem, it's not me, it's the evil inclination, please help me. But immediately, pick up yourself. Because Hashem knows that we're human beings. And He knows we have emotions, and not always the rational can control the emotions. Even though, look, the heart is here and the head is here. But still, the distance between both of them is like 500 years. But we are working on it, that it will be one. That everything that we do, that we will all accept with love, everything that happens to us. So this is how we teach our children. So always bless your children. You go to sleep, always forgive them. Always, when you go to sleep, forgive your children. And not only your children, when you go to sleep, when you say Shema Yisrael, before you say Shema Yisrael, Shema Yisrael Shalamita, when you sit on the bed to say Shema Yisrael, we say, Ribono Shel Olam, Hareini Mochelet Lechol Mishich Is V'Iknit Oti, O Shechata Kenegdi, Ben Begufi, Ben Okay, so I'm forgiving the Lord of the Universe. I'm forgiving everybody that made me angry, everybody that teased me or sinned towards me. Ben begufi, if it's with my body, ben bemamoni, if it's with my money, ben bichvodi, if it's with my honor, ben bechol asher li, anything that belongs to me, ben beones, ben beratzon, if it was by force or by willing, which means he didn't want to do it, but somebody forced him to do this. Or he wanted to do it. Ben beshogeg, ben bemeziv. Even if he did it unintentionally, or he did it on purpose. Ben bemachshava, even if he did it in thought. Ben bedibur, even in speech. Ben bemase, even in action. Ben begilgul ze, ben begilgul acher. Even in this reincarnation or previous reincarnation, we don't want to have any cheshbonot, any calculation with anyone, because if we do. And if we don't forgive, we have to come again with the same people. Because even Yom Kippurim does not atone for sins between us and other human beings. We'll have to come again. Can you imagine? And if we come again as human beings, because reincarnation can be in four forms. One is in still things, domim. The second one is in plants. And the third one is in animals. And the fourth one is in human beings. The reincarnation as the domain, still things, plants and animals, the soul remembers everything. All of the previous reincarnations, what it was, if it was a big minister, a poor person, everything it remembers. But it's caught. Can you imagine? It can be caught in a body of an like the cat that came to the kotel, to the Western Wall, and started praying to God there. Can you imagine how suffering the soul has? It remembers that it was a human being and now it's caught in an animal. But when we come as human beings, we don't remember. Then what happens, either we do the fixed thing or we don't do it and we do worse. So forgive everyone. Remember, everything is, this is a passing world. We are building the world, our world to come in this world. Only here we have the tools to build our world to come in this world. Only here we can follow the commandments. Once we pass away, we can't follow any commandment because v'metim chofshi, King David says, chapter 88 in David's Psalms, that when you are dead, when you pass away, then you're not obligated with the mitzvot anymore. That's it. So, dear ladies, even this in this implantation, we say that we forgive them even in thought, in speech, and in action. Because every mitzvah that we do, and every the opposite of a mitzvah that we do, when we don't listen to Hashem, it's the clothing of it is three parts. It's the thought, it's the speech, and the action. Because once we have the thought, nobody knows our thoughts. Only God knows our thoughts. But once we take it out of our mouth, the ear is a microphone to all of the organs of the body. From there to action, the way is short. So we say in this reincarnation and previous reincarnation, lechol ben Israel, to all of the children of Israel, velo yanesh shum adam besibati, and nobody will be punished because of me. יירצון מלפניך השם אלוקי ואלוקי אבותי, let it be your will, my God and my God of my forefathers, שלא אכתה עוד, that I won't sin anymore, ולא אחזור בהם, and I won't repeat these sins, ולא אשוב עוד להכעיסך, and I won't make you angry. Truly, Hashem is not angry. And truly, it's not a punishment. When we go through suffering, it's not a punishment. It's in order to cleanse us from the destructive angels that we created. We created jealousy, lust, and honor, take a human being out of this world. We created by our own actions. You know, when a person is mature, it's when he takes responsibility over his own actions, and he doesn't blame others. ולא אשוב עוד להכעיסך, ולא אעשה הרע בעיניך, and I won't do things that you don't like, Hashem. ומה שחטאתי לפניך, and the things that I did not in your will, מחוק ברחמך, רבים, please erase them with your mercy, because only the mercy. He is the King of Kings. Hashem created the universe. So Hashem can give us a pardon. So we just ask from Hashem, please, this is the path that we want to go through. Give us a pardon. So Bezrat Hashem, but we have to show, we have to recognize that we are not doing things that Hashem likes. Because if a person goes like a horse, that he has something on his eyes, so he doesn't even recognize it. So when he doesn't recognize, there's nothing to ask forgiveness for. And furthermore, it's even worse, because you don't understand where these suffering and challenges are coming from. And when a person doesn't understand and has complaints, God forbid, for God, then not only that his suffering are not softened, but they become harsher. Because what happens when we complain, they open our book in heaven and they say, okay, let's see if this person says that Hashem has, God forbid, just. Let's see what he really deserves. So not only the suffering do not become softened, but it becomes harsher. Can you imagine? Can you imagine what we do? We do it to ourselves. So, dear ladies, we continue, and it says, and please, Hashem, erase our sins with your great mercy, אבל לא על ידי סורים וחולאים רעים, but not by sickness and suffering. In a good way, Hashem. So, בעזרת Hashem, Hashem has a lot of mercy, but dear ladies. So, we see over here how we should behave also to our children. And I know that it's very important what we take out of our mouth. Very important. So, ישתדלו ההורים תמיד לברך את ילדיהם. We always, the parents, should make an effort to bless their children. If you don't have anything good to say, just don't say it. Just don't say it. Take a glass of water, say שהכל נהיה בדברו, that everything that was created was created by the word of Hashem. And then you remember that אין בריאה נוקפת אצבע למטה, לא יחריץ זו עליה למעלה. There's no human being that can do something here unless it was declared in heaven. So, ובפרט בערב שבת כמנהג ישראל, and especially on the night of Shabbat, it's a custom with the children of Israel, דייש לחו שמה במשך השבוע, הקפידו וכעסו עליהם, because maybe during the week, the parents were angry with their children, so this is the time to bless your children. וקפידתם עלולה להזיק להם, and if the parents were angry in their hearts or in their mouth, because if you want to teach and you just show anger only with your mouth in order to put the child in place, that's something else. But if it touches your heart, then this is a problem. Because Hashem says there are three combined to create a human being. It's God and his father and mother. And when God sees, when Hashem sees that there's no respect to the parents, then God says, I shouldn't be here. So, and then, chas v'shalom, God forbid, he can punish our children, and it's not punishment, but by the destructive angels that they create, they come back to them. So we don't want this. So Bezrat Hashem, only bless your children. ולכן הבנים נוהגים לנשק ידי אביהם ואימם אחר הקידוש בליל שבת. So the sons and daughters are accustomed to kiss the hand of their parents after the kiddush on the night of Shabbat. וההורים מברכים אותם, and the parents bless them. יש לי פה את עבודת השם, the סידור of עבודת השם. And what do they bless them? So everything, first of all, that we want. That usually the parents put their hands on the head of the children, and they bless them like this. Okay. For the boy, the father says, "Yesimcha Elokim keEfraim veChimnashe." That Hashem will put you like Ephraim and Menashe, the two sons of Yosef, that they have peace among them and they loved each other without any jealousy. And then, yes, for the daughter, Yesimech Elokim keSarah Rivka Rachel veLeah. That Hashem will make you like our foremothers, Sarah Rivka Rachel veLeah. And then the parents bless them, the triple blessing of the Kohanim, Birkat HaKohanim, Mivarkecha Hashem Vishmerecha, Ya'er Hashem Pana Velecha Vichuneka, Yisa Hashem Pana Velecha Viyasem Lecha Shalom, Vesamu Et Shnei Adnei Yisrael Vani Yavarchem. And I'm reminding you, because we have 14 parts in our hands, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, Yad, 10, in numerical value is Yod, is letter Yod. 4 is letter Dalet. Together it's Yad, Mamash, literally a hand. But it has the triple blessing of the Kohanim here. This I'm saying now in the name of Rabbi Chaim Yosef Sharabi, Alav Shalom Dishmuto Tzorah B'Tzorah Chaim. Yavarkecha Hashem Vishmerecha, Ya'er Hashem Pana Velecha Vichuneka, Yisa Hashem Pana Velecha Viyasem Lecha Shalom. So this is Birkat HaKohanim. We have a lot of secrets in our hands. So, B'Siyata Dishmaya, this is the minhag to give our children bracha the night of Shabbat. And before you go to sleep, always forgive them. And always bless them. That you will have Yiddish, Chassidish, and Nachat from all of your children. That they will all be righteous and walk in the path of Hashem. And they will build a home, eternal home that is based on Torah and commandments and mitzvot Bezrat Hashem. And the children kiss the hands of their parents. וההורים מברכים אותם, and the parents bless them. ובן נשוי, and a son that is already married, המתגורר בסמוך להוריו, that lives close to his parents, נכון והגון שילך בחולל שבת להוריו לנשק את ידיהם. It's appropriate that he will go at the night of Shabbat to their home, that he will kiss their hands. ואף אם הדבר גורם לעיכוב הקידוש בביתו, even if it will postpone the kiddush that he does for his wife at home and the children, he should first go to his parents and kiss their hands. Because when the parents bless you, you are blessed, your wife is blessed, your children are blessed. Because שלושה שותפים לו לאדם, three people are combined to create a human being. Three, God, father and mother. So the blessing is like blessing from Hashem. And don't forget that the angels say amen. ומן הראוי שהבן ילך אצל הוריו, ובפרט באמא שאלמנה שהבן מקדש עבורה. So it's appropriate that the son will go to his parents, especially for a mother that is a widow and the son is doing kiddush for her. ואם אשתו מתנגדת לכך מחמת שהקידוש בביתה מתעכב, if his wife doesn't like it because the kiddush, he postpones the kiddush at home, maybe they have little children and they want to sleep. נכון שהבעל יסביר לה את חשיבות מצוות כיבוד אב ואם. So the husband should speak nice with his wife and explain to her how much it's important, וישכנע אותה להסכים לזה, and persuade her to agree to this. ואם בכל זאת הדבר מפריע לה, in further this his wife doesn't agree, he should go to a chacham, to a rabbi, and to ask what to do. טוב ונכון שאדם ירגיל את בנו הקטן לנשק את ידיו. So first we teach by example. So when we do it, our children see it and they also do it. But it's appropriate to teach our children from when they're young to kiss the hands of their parents. וידי אמו ורבו, and the hand of the father, the mother, and the rabbi. ושאר גדולים וחסידים, and all of the scholars in Torah. וכן המנהג אצלנו הספרדים. This is our minhag, the custom of the ספרדים. צריך להשתדל מאוד לקבל ברכת אבי ואמו אפילו כל ימות השנה. We should make an effort that to get the blessing of our father and mother during the whole year, not only on the night of Shabbat, but during the whole year. ומכל שכן בערב יום הכיפורים. And furthermore, at the eve of Yom Kippurim, of course, to go and ask forgiveness from them and to see that they will bless us Bezrat Hashem. And he who blesses others is blessed. And it says, furthermore, I'm going to הרחבה על זה. It's written בגמרא, it's written in the Gemara, עבודה זרה, page 17, עמוד א', אמרו שהמורה אולה, this is one of the big חכמים of the Gemara, כאשר היה חוזר מבית המדרש, when he used to come back from the yeshiva, from studying Torah, היה מנשק ידי אביו. He would kiss the hand of his father. And Rashi says there, שכך דרך בני אדם, that this is the custom of human beings, שכאשר יוצא מבית הכנסת, when you go out of the shul, of the synagogue, מנשק ידי אביו ואמו, והגדולים ממנו בפס ידיהם. Gives a kiss to his father and mother over here on their hand, and also the rabbi and all of the big scholars. And it says, this is Rashi says about Avodah, Masechet Avodah Zarah, page 17. And in the Zohar HaKadosh, Parashat Lech Lecha, we just had, we had Parashat Lech Lecha a few weeks ago. So אמרו שרבי אלעזר, בנו של רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, so the son of רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, רבי אלעזר, וכן כל תלמידי רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, all of the students of רבי שמעון בר יוחאי, היו מנשקים את ידיו. They would kiss the hand of רבי שמעון בר יוחאי. וכן היה נוהג, and get a bracha from him, a blessing from him. וכן היה נוהג רבינו אריזל. The אריזל would do the same thing. כלפי אמו הצדקנית, towards his mother, שבכל ליל שבת היה הולך לביתה, every night of Shabbat he would go to her home, ומנשק את ידה, and he would kiss her hand. והיא הייתה מברכת אותו, and she would bless him. See how much is important. Please mute yourselves. ומכאן שרבינו אריזל גילה בזה איזה טעם על פי הקבלה שבליל שבת דווקא יש מעלה גדולה בברכת האם ובנשיקת ידה. That because especially on the night of Shabbat it's a big thing to kiss the hand of your mother. A big מעלה. It says בשאר הכוונות של אריזל, it says after you went davening, you prayed in shul בכניסתך לבית, when you come out, it's the night of Shabbat, תאמר בקול רם, say in a loud voice, ובשמחה יתרה, and also with happiness, Shabbat Shalom, good Shabbos for everyone, כי הוא, and it says it's like a חתן, כחתן המקבל את הקלה בשמחה גדולה. It's like a groom that accepts the bride with a big happiness. ובספר פנים יפות, and with brightness in your face. ואם אמך קיימת בחיים, and if your mother is alive, בחיים חיותה, תלך ותנשק ותנשוק ידיה. Go and kiss her hands. And it says why? Because this is about Z'er Anpin, that and now meets Kichen Z'er Anpin Noshek Yedei Imo Bechol El Shabbat, that kisses the hand of his mother every Shabbat. This is part of the Kabbalah, but it's a big secret. So it's a big thing to kiss your father and mother's hands, especially your mother on the night of Shabbat. And it says, ובשאר הכוונות הסביר את טעם הדבר, we just spoke about it, וכן לימד רבנו אריזל את תלמידו רבי חיים ויטל, so even אריזל told his student רבי חיים ויטל, וכן כתב רבנו מרן אחידה, רבי חיים יוסף דוד אזולאי עליו שלום זכותות הגנה לנו עם הסבוק, מורה אצבע, שכאשר ינשק ידי אבי ואמו, when he kisses the hands of his mother, father and mother, יכוון שמקיים בזה מצוות כיבוד הורים. and that he will have an intention that by this he's following the commandment of respecting thy father and mother. And when he kisses the hand of his mother, he should have an intention that there's a secret by the Kabbalah. And by this Kabbalah, this is what he's doing. Let Hashem do the Kavanot. Hashem knows the Kavanot. But we, Tamim Tiem Hashem Be'Elohecha, be wholehearted with Hashem your God. And also, Rabbi Agaon, Rabbi Ben Zion Abba Shaul, Zechar Tzadik Livracha Alav Shom Sotot Hagan Aleinu, Bizman She'agar Beshchenut, when he lived close to his mother, so he would go every night of Shabbat to the house, to his mother's house, in order that he, that kiss her hand and get her blessings. V'yesh, and there's a different minhagim, customs. So when exactly it's the time to get the blessings of your parents? Some say after they come back home from the shul and after shalom aleichem, and after they are singing shalom aleichem, then kodem hakiddush, before the kiddush, they kiss the hands of the parents and then they get the blessing. And some say after the kiddush, it depends on the minhag, on the custom. And some after the kiddush do that. Depends on the minhag. Okay, and the most of the Ashkenazim, Berov Ashkenazim, except for some of the Hasidim, lo nagu bichlal bekibudim ele, they don't have this custom. Shenam regilim bichlal benishikat hayad, they don't have the custom of kissing the hand. Even though this is a very old custom, and they don't kiss the hands of the rabbis, not all of them, but some, but they have the custom of shaking a hand and getting a blessing by the shaking of the hand. Also for their custom, they should be very careful. Everybody should be very careful with respect of father and mother, and come and get a blessing from the father and mother, especially on the night of Shabbat. Okay, and also Baal Reshit Chochma, Rabbi Eliyahu Divida, Shalom Shom Zechutot Hagan Aleinu, Zechar Tzadik Livracha, that was the Talmid of Aramak, Rabbi Moshe Cordovero, and he wrote there Bereshit Chochma, בשער גידול, in the gate of raising your children, שילמד כל אדם את בנם כשהם קטנים, that a person should teach his children when they are still small, לנשק ידי ההורים וידי הגדולים בחסידים, to kiss the hands of his father and mother, and also the rabbi and the chachamim and all of the scholars in Torah, and ask for a blessing, בעזרת השם. So dear ladies, and we'll continue next time, Bezrat Hashem, with the halachot regarding respecting their father and mother and rabbis. We didn't start the scholars in Torah, Bezrat Hashem. Now we're going to Ilchot Shabbat. We're going to speak about, we are on the 31st activity of Shabbat. Remember, we started Baruch Hashem, the 39 activities are forbidden on Shabbat by the Torah and by our rabbis. And we are now at the 31st Melach activity. And this is Mechataich, cutting. Okay, just a minute, let me open the books. The last one that we had is scoring. You remember ruling lines. And now, after you rule lines on the hides, on the skin and the fur, now you have to cut it. Okay? As a mechatech, measured cutting. Okay? As אנחנו, this is by Shulchan Aruch ורב עובדי יוסף. אנחנו בספר מלאכת שבת. So it's written, החותך דבר במידה מסוימת. So a person who cuts a measured cutting, שצריך להקפיד בעל חיתוך מנויג על פי צורך מסוים. For example, with a paper or leather or a stone or matechet metal or wood and everything like this, it refers to everything. הרי זה אסור משום מחתך. Now this is prohibited because of measured cutting. It's a 31st melacha activity that is forbidden by the Torah. It's part of what they used to do in the Mishkan. They used to cut leather, they used to cut the hide, the skin, the fur in measured pieces in order to sew it, to make big curtains or garments. So in order to sew it, so this is when we cut it to a measured cutting, then this is a prohibition by the Torah to do that on Shabbat. Okay, and it says shiur isur mechatech beor kasheu. So the prohibition of cutting and by this violating a prohibition on Shabbat by the Torah for hard skin, or kasheh is hard skin. When you cut a piece of hard skin in order to cover an amulet, and with a soft skin, which means a piece that you can write on it, an amulet, a parchment. Okay, ראוי מלכתחילה להכין מבעוד יום, טוב, we'll come to it in a few minutes because I have a few things before that. So there are different forms of mechatech, which is measured cutting. There are different forms of it. And for example, cutting any object to a specific side is called mechatech. There are two points of view over here. There's disagreement between rabbis. For example, I'll give you the disagreement, and we'll talk about it also next week about this disagreement. Rav Shlomo Zalman Oirbach, Alav Shlomo Zchotot Agnalenu, he says that the melacha of a measured cutting has to have an intention. You have to have an intention that you want to cut this on purpose to do another thing. So, which means, if you intentionally do that, then you are violating the prohibition of mechatech. So, which means of measured cutting. Lumat zot, Rav Eliashiv, Rav Yosef Shalom Eliashiv, Alav Shalom Zchotot Agnalenu, he says that it doesn't make a difference if you have an intention or you don't have intention. But if you're making exact cut, then you're violating the prohibition of mechatech, which is a measured cutting. Anyway, you are violating a prohibition on Shabbat, because if it's not a mechatech, if it's not a measured cutting, then it's referred as tearing, korea. So anyway, you're violating, but in two different aspects. But I won't go to it now. We're going to go to this next week, Be'ezrat Hashem. Meanwhile, we'll continue over here. So examples for mechatech. For example, because this regards the difference between mechatech, measured cutting, and korea, which is tearing, as for first of all, that mechatech, measured mechatech, measured cutting is for everything. Paper, wood, like I told you before, paper, wood, metal, stone, paper, everything. And the opposite of this is korea. Korea is only, it's limited to soft things and limited to playable materials. Okay, which means a measured cutting applies to all materials, opposite of it is a korea, which is tearing, and tearing applies only to soft material and a playable material. Now I'm giving you examples. For example, as sharpening a pencil. So sharpening a pencil is also regarded as mechatech. We said about wood. So sharpening a pencil is also, but it's considered mechatech, measured cutting. But it's also, it can be makebe patish, which means hitting with a hammer, which means finishing the line. Because if, let's say, if the pencil is new, so in order to use it, you have to sharpen it. Or if when you sharpen it, it broke. So again, you have to sharpen it. But this is already makebe patish. So this is not only mechatech. It's not only, but you violate two activities on Shabbat. Okay, tearing off a piece of wax to cover wires of orthodontic braces is also mechatech. Also a straw, cutting a straw or a toothpick, it's to make it shorter. This is also mechatech on Shabbat, you're not allowed. Tearing up paper into measured small sizes is mechatech. And if you tear it, because it's small measured sizes, it's considered measured cutting, mechatech. Achshav, what happens if you do this? So this with all of this can be also with a machine, which means scissors or knife or any instrument that you need in order to do measured cutting. But what happens of measured cutting with a hand? So know that it's a prohibition. If you use your hands or you use an instrument, it's still a prohibition of mechatech of measured cutting. Now, dear ladies, because measured cutting by hand, it's a rabbinical prohibition. So anyway, it falls, either it's a prohibition by instruments by the Torah or prohibition by hand by rabbis. So it's rabbinical prohibition. What about mechatech in food? When we cut the food. So any sur chituch bo chalin, lechen mutar lechtoch kol davar lezorech achila. A measured cutting does not apply to food, because the measured cutting is part of me'abed, of processing. We process the hide and the skin, because everything that we are learning now, all of the nine activities, we started by the order of hide. So in order to sew it and to make curtains and a covering and to make garments, so this does not apply. So this does not apply to food. So ein isur chituch bo chalin, lachen mutar lechtoch kol davar lo tzorech achila. So that, because it doesn't apply to food, then we are allowed to cut food b'siyata dishmaya. Anything that we want to eat, we're allowed to cut it. Which means fish, challah, meat, anything for Shabbat, a cake, everything that you want. What happens if we didn't do it intentionally? Okay, when the cutting is intentional, because this is part. You remember there's a disagreement between Rabbi Shlomo Zalman Oirbach Halav Shlom Sotot Agen Aleinu and the Rav. Yosef Shalom Eliashiv Alav Hashem Zchotot Hagen Aleinu, they had a disagreement about this, whether it's considered violating the prohibition of measured cutting, mechatech, or it's a prohibition of korea, of tearing. So we see over here that there has to be part of the definition that it has to be an intention and calculated, which means before that we did ruling line scoring, okay, mesotet before that. So let's look for examples. Tearing tamper proof safety seals on perforated lines, okay, like in a cottage, cottage cheese, yogurt, butter, anything you know that has dots over there, and we just open it in order to use it. So we are allowed to do that. There's no prohibition of doing that because it's a tamper-proof safety, and even though it's combined, there's a plastic on it, a thin plastic strip. We are allowed to cut it in order. We are allowed to break it in order to use it. Okay. Another thing, the cups of wine and grape juice bottles may also be broken in the perforated line, because in all of the cases we don't mean it. It's easier to do that. That's why they make it like this, because in order it will be easier. But we don't have any intention in order to do this. We just want to open it. And we just it's easier to serve and to remove the seal. And also, there's no problem of korea over here. It's not also considered a violating a korea, which is a tearing. Opening small packets of sugar, salt, mustard, ketchup, like we have in a hotel, you know, hotel styles packages. So it's also, we are allowed to do that. We are allowed to cut them on Shabbat because this is not, we don't have any intent. We're just using the inner part of the packet, and it's allowed to do that on Shabbat. Okay, opening a box of tissues. Dear ladies, opening a box of tissues, you see, with this that is perforated over here that we can open, we're not allowed to do on Shabbat. It's not only that it violates measured cutting, but it also violates makebe patish. Because this is the end, of the activity, which means the end. Let me find the right translation for this. Makebe patish is the finishing thing that we need to do in order to use this package. So the finishing thing is to open it. So on Shabbat we cannot open it over here in the perforated. In the perforated line, dots that have the lines, the dots that they have over there. I think the next thing that we are going to do is to continue next time with this. I'm just finishing. Ra'ui melechatchila lachin mib'od yom niyar toilet chatuch. So also toilet paper we should prepare before Shabbat, or you take a tissue, and we spoke about it. We spoke about Korea, when we spoke about tearing, we spoke about it with Dachak, and what happens if you, let's say you cut the toilet paper, now you don't have, and it's finished, but because of the dignity of a human being, then you cut it in a different way. Instead of cutting it like this, you cut it with your hands like this, in a different way, and not in the perforated place. So, כשאין נייר חתוך, מותר לפתוח בשינוי, you're allowed in a change, to cut it, kegon biyat small, like in the left hand, and also try not to cut it in the perforated lines. Sakiyot mazon kegon shel chalav, matzot, ugot, mamtakim v'chadome, so packages of the food, of milk, matzah, cakes, candies, you know, that has a plastic on it, mutar, you're allowed to open it on Shabbat. We'll speak further about it next week, Bezrat Hashem, ilchatchila b'Shabbat, af al pi shemechatech, so even though it's a measured cutting, but still you're allowed, especially if it's in a way that you make it that you cannot use it anymore. So any sumechatech ba'ochalin, we said that there's no prohibition regarding measured cutting in food, and besiata dishmaya will continue next time. So you're allowed to cut the food. I'll show you here. You see meat, challah, anything, or a cake, anything, you're allowed to cut it. Now we are going to Netzor Leshoncha, Chafetz Chaim, we're learning regarding our tongue. Okay, we are in the part, you remember, we spoke about the ways of repenting for slandering, gossiping, telltelling, and lying, which is very harsh to lie. So, dear ladies, it's written, "Meniata machala yerefua tova biyotel." So, prevention of the sickness is the best cure, which means we need to teach ourselves to guard our tongue. העובדה, כי כדי לחפר על חטאו, חייב המדבר לשון הרע, לגשת אל האיש שבגנותו דיבר ולבקש ממנו מחילה. So in order to atone for the sin of slandering, I'm not speaking about lying, slandering, it can be the true things, only to belittle and disgrace a person. Because if we think, we have to think first, is this necessary or it's all for our ego? So, dear ladies, in order to atone for it, we have to go to the person that we spoke about and ask for him forgiveness. Dayal avi lekach shanashim yizaharu v'yirasnu atzma mildaber leshon hara. So, only this is enough for people to limit themselves and restrain themselves from speaking lashon hara, of slandering. Why? בדרך כלל אדם מתבייש לגלות לחברו כי דיבר בגנותו. Usually a person is ashamed to tell another person, I didn't speak nice about you. We need to have a lot of כוחות נפש. You have to have a lot of courage. והוא זקוק למאמץ נפשי רב כדי לעשות זאת. And he needs a lot of courage in order to go to his friend and tell him, I spoke badly about you. בפרט כאשר במקרים רבים לולא הודעתו אין חברו יודע כלל כי הוא דיבר בגנותו ופגע בכבודו. And in many cases, his friend doesn't even know that he spoke about him and he disgraced his honor. אולם ישנו גורם אחרי יותר שבגללו חשוב מאוד להיזהר. So one thing that it's very important to guard ourselves not to slander, not to gossip, not to lie, is this. It's very hard to come because Hashem says, עבירות בין אדם לחברו, the sins between us and other human beings, he does not atone for them unless we went to that person and asked forgiveness from him. Okay, so dear ladies, this is not easy, and a person has to have a lot of inner courage in order to go to tell a person, I've sinned towards you, I did A, B, C. And he doesn't know how his friend is going to react to this. So the second thing that we should guard ourselves and be cautious not to do that, to help ourselves prevent from doing this, אולם ישנו גורם מכריע יותר, and it's even harsher than the first reason, שבגללו חשוב מאוד להיזהר מדיבור לשון הרע. במקרים רבים כמעט בלתי אפשרי לעשות תשובה על חטא. Most of the time it's almost impossible to do a tshuva, to repent over this sin of slandering. Why? מי שמורגל בלשון הרע אינו מסוגל לזכור, he who is regular for slandering, that it's like he eats and drinks. So it says over here, אינו מסוגל לזכור את כל אותם האנשים שדיבר בגנותם ופגע בהם. He can't remember all of the people that he spoke about and hurt them and all of the people that he told them. Because he has to go to everyone in order to atone for this. ואינו יכול לבקש מהם מחילה. And then he can't even ask forgiveness from them. And remember, there's an eye that sees, an ear that listens, and all our actions are written in a book. And every word that we spoke is written in a book. We are judged for every word, every letter in the word. Can you imagine? This is how tough the judgment is in heaven. Because when a person comes to this world, he comes with a limited amount of daily words that he can use. Holy words, encouragement, it's tzedakah, charity that we do with our mouth. We're speaking about the Torah, speaking shira shirim tehilim perek shira, everything tzedakah that we do with our mouth to other people, this is unlimited. But the limitation is over all of the words that we use for our livelihood. So when a person finishes yet nafshi yatzah bedabro, it's written in King Solomon says in shira shirim, it's that my soul went out with my speech. When we finish the amount of words of livelihood that we receive from Hashem, then we pass from this world. But there's no limitation over holy words, over tzedakah, that charity that we do with our mouth. This is not limited. So and now he has to remember everyone that he spoke about, and remember that three people die from slandering. And slandering, so this is slandering, I'm not speaking about lying about people. And slandering is parallel to worshiping other gods, having intimate relationship that is forbidding, and murdering, spilling the blood of another human being. All of this is slandering. You know, people who speak about you and belittle you and gossip about you, you should give them a present, because you get all of the mitzvot. You get all of the mitzvot. Hashem cleans them out of their mitzvot and gives it to you. And your sins go to them. That's a good bargain. That's why our sages say it's better when people put you down than, God forbid, by this you atone for your sins, and not, God forbid, make you sick or something will happen, God forbid, to your children or your income or something. So, okay, people speak about you, but they don't even realize that in a split of a second, all of the Tehillim, all of the Perek Shira, all of the Tikkun HaKlali, everything, all of the Shacharit, Mincha V'Arvit, everything, all of the mitzvot, it just gave as a present to you. They just gave it as a mincha to you. So, Baruch Hashem. So, a person who is regular to do this, and kimat, it's barely forgivable. Because he has to go to everyone that he spoke. That's why I told you last time at the last lesson that you have to ask help from Hashem. Tell him, Hashem, I don't remember who I spoke. If you're already 60 years old, you don't remember everyone in the way. So Hashem, please help me that I will atone everything. I want to come in front of the throne of Hashem after a long life and a good life that Hashem forgave from everything. Just go to paradise and sit with all of the righteous and enjoy the divine presence. So Bezrat Hashem, and I told you that also learn two halachot every day of Lashon Hara, of slandering, like we are studying from Chafetz Chaim, Bezrat Hashem. And nosaf lekach, hu asui litim kovot ledaber odot pigmei mishpacha. So sometimes also a person speaks about the family of that person and finds defaults and defects on it. Davar she'ein lo mechila. The Chafetz Chaim says that this is unforgivable. It's not only that he sinned towards this person, but also to father, mother, grandparents, all of them that came before him. Mishum she'ashpa'at ha'dvarim yechola la'zik ledorei dorot u'bilti efshari le'vesh mechila al kach. Because the influence of these words, I'm sorry, they're renovating downstairs and upstairs. I hope you can hear me. So because this can influence generations to come, and there's no forgiveness for this. So you have to teach yourself to prevent this, even if you, because what does the evil inclination wants us to take the words out of our mouth. So even if we feel that we want to take it out of our mouth, restrain yourself. Remember, it's not worth it. And it's only your ego. That's from the evil inclination. Every human being has the soul from Hashem. And it's a precious soul. This energy of life is from God. And it's a precious soul. So we need to respect each other and to love each other. God knows that we love Him by loving each other, by respecting each other. You think you're putting a different person down, you're just putting yourself down. You're fooling only yourself, because all of your mitzvot went to the other person that you spoke of. Baruch Hashem. So another thing that I want to put nekudaze. So it's sins that bear fruits. So slandering and gossiping and lying about a person on the internet, on the TV, on the media, everywhere. This bear fruits, because even if you, let's say, you forgot about it. But even after you pass away, it's still on the internet, it's still on the social media, it's still on the TV, radio. You can hear it again and again, which means you cause people to sin again and again. This has fruits, even if you're not here in this world. How much we have to be careful with everything that we take out of our mouth. I would like to bless all of us, Bezrat Hashem, that Hashem will help us to restrain ourselves, and that we will be worthy of receiving Mashiach Tziten b'mera b'yamin ramein Eliyahu Nabi Zechu L'Tov L'Olam Yipered Adam Mechaboru B'dbar Halachai Yachid ורבים הלכה כרבים. אחינו כל בית ישראל הנתונים בצרה ובשביה עומדים בין בים ובין ביבשה, המקום ירחם עליהם ויוצאים מצרה לרווחה ומאפלה לאורה, משיבוד לגאולה, השתא בעגלה בזמן קריב יברו, אמן. גוד שבת, שבת שלום ובורך.